When do we add in the alcohol?
Good question, as I'm about to pour it in.
Oh.
I didn't do it yet, so.
Oh, good, 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 good.
Hi, welcome to another episode of Chemists in the Kitchen. Today we are talking about ice cream. We're going to be talking about flavors and textures, sugar content, and why store-bought ice cream tastes different than homemade ice cream.
Hi, my name is Adrian. I am a polymer scientist that works in ostomy and healthcare.
Hi, my name is Robin Mays. I'm a chemical engineer. I specialize in plastics and understanding their
I'm Victoria Lai, and I'm the owner and chief ice creampreneur of Ice Cream Jubilee. We've won Best Ice Cream in Washington, D.C. 7 years in a row and been named Best in America by People Magazine, Thrillist, Food & Wine Magazine, and more. So I got into ice cream not because I had a background in ice cream science. I was actually an attorney, but I loved ice cream flavors, and I still do. So one of my favorite ice cream memories is with my sister and my dad. Whenever he would come home a little bit late from work, my sister and I would jump out of bed and run down while he was eating dinner so we could have ice cream with him. It was a happy moment that we would share together, and we would smush things into our ice cream. We would call it inventions, even though it was just strawberries or candies inside of our ice cream, but it was the experimentation that we loved to try and that time together that I'll always remember.
I just always being attached to like mint chocolate chip, and every place I would go, no matter where it would be, I would be like mint chocolate. Robin, you're shaking your head. Is that not like a flavor that you like at all? Like,
when I think of homemade ice cream, I definitely think of growing up. My grandfather, who we called Papal, grew peaches in his backyard, and so he would take the peaches and make homemade fresh peach ice cream every summer, which was the greatest thing ever.
What sort of machine did you have?
Oh yeah, what machine?
So we always used the rock salt manual crank. And when I was little, I could sit on top of the barrel and just like crank it while sitting on it because I didn't weigh too much. As a kid, I didn't want to do manual labor, but for ice cream, it was totally worth it.
So another one of my favorite ice cream memories is when my cousin had a birthday party and it was themed Minnesota State Fair. Of course, one part of it was an ice cream competition. One of the competitors came up with this flavor that's now one of our top selling flavors. So the reason I thought that banana bourbon caramel would be a great flavor for Chemists in the Kitchen is that there are so many different ingredients and components that could potentially change the texture of your ice cream. So you start with your custard, and then you have bananas, which is the fruit, and then you have the sugars from the caramel, and of course bourbon. So what you're gonna need for this is heavy cream, whole milk, eggs, sugar, and a little bit of salt. And that's the fundamentals of making a custard or creme anglaise. But we're gonna make that ahead of time and let that chill in the fridge. With that base, you can make almost any flavor. But for this, we're gonna add bananas, and then we're gonna add bourbon, and then we're gonna make a caramel to swirl it through at the end.
For the viewers at home, we've done some of this stuff beforehand because I don't think you guys wanna watch us stir things for an hour. But yeah, Robin, tell me what your experience was like, because this is the first time I tried doing this kind of formulation.
Yeah, me too. So you heat the milk and the cream together first until they're just barely boiling, and then you add a mixture of egg yolk and sugar that you've whisked up together, and then you heat it up again, but you don't want it too hot because you can definitely scramble the eggs. So you just want it hot enough so that it's all nice and thick. And the classic cooking trick is that you dip a spoon in, and then if you drag your finger across the back of the spoon and it leaves a nice clean line, then your custard is probably done. So this custard smells amazing, tastes amazing. I'm really excited for it to be ice cream. How about you, Adrian?
Can you show the camera what your custard looks like? Because I want to know.
My custard is thick, but it's liquidy. I don't know if you
Oh gosh, Victoria wasn't over our shoulders when we did these kinds of things. So my custard looks like this, so I don't know if I can see it jiggle a little bit. I'll do the spoon test. So I don't know if that's supposed to be like, if you can see this a little bit better. Yeah, you can see it kind of hang there. It's got a little bit of, do Do you have the same thing, Robin?
Yeah, it's the same.
That looks great. That looks really great, guys.
Okay, good, good.
And that's another reason that I went into ice cream. You can experiment so much, and you never totally end up with something that's bad.
I have now, it's a staple of Chicago, it's this thing called Malort. And I don't know if you've ever been here, but Malort is like, it tastes like wormwood. It's terrible. It's the worst drink. It tastes awful. And so one of the things I've had as an idea is like, how can you make something so terrible taste into something good? One of the things I was thinking of, could you put Malort in there? And if you gave that reaction to people in Chicago, they'd be like, ugh, you know, so yeah, I mean, there's lots of things to try, but apparently there is a good challenge of seeing how can you make a terrible ice cream?
That's like, for me, one of the coolest, most engineering-y things about the ice cream process is, you know, I grew up with the rock and salt, which is like an endothermic reaction that sucks heat out of the ice cream mixture to freeze it. But the compressor, that's like a classic engineering heat cycle where you compress down the fluid, and then when you let it expand again, it cools down, which is like...
Yeah.
All engineering students learn this in thermodynamics. So I'm excited for this like fancy technology that's gonna make my ice cream instead of the hand crank.
Why don't you guys walk us through your machines and tell us about how they're different from others?
To my knowledge, there's three major kinds of ice cream makers. There's the old fashioned rock and salt, where you have kind of a moat of rock and salt. And then on the inside, you have a canister of your ice cream mixture and you're turning the paddle or the canister. And then there's the kind where you have a barrel that basically has a coolant, kind of like an ice pack. So you put that in your freezer, let it freeze, and then you pour the ice cream in it. The problem with that one is that canister doesn't get any cooler than your freezer does, so that ice cream tends to be a little bit softer. But a compressor is like what's cooling your freezer, what's running your refrigerator, what's running your air conditioner, so it can get pretty cold. So I think it'll do a really good job of freezing our ice cream.
So what we're gonna do with this, because we're scientists and there's so many different levers that we can pull, I'm gonna give you some flexibility with your ingredients. This is your ice cream to make and it's up to you, so go nuts. The fun thing to play with is how much bourbon goes in. Some people say 1 tablespoon is enough. If you wanna go crazy, add some more. Just make a bourbon ice cream.
These are soft, like how are your bananas, Robin? These are all kind of mushy and like really kind of gross.
Yeah, mine is like, it's got the black spots, but it's not totally black, so. I've got some spices here. Aside from, there's vanilla in the custard. What spices do you think I should add to really like kick this up?
So we recommend adding traditional pie spices, because that's gonna give you that hint of banana bread, baked goods, warming spices that the bourbon sort of alludes to. So that's cinnamon, nutmeg, and clove. Clove is the strongest, so don't add too much.
When do we add in the alcohol?
Good question, as I'm about to pour it in.
Oh.
I didn't do it yet, so.
Oh, good, 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 good.
So one thing to remember, scientists, is that with the sugar and alcohol, the freezing point will be lowered. So as we put the flavored ice cream custard into your ice cream machine, we want it to get to a more solidified, soft serve texture. If we add the bourbon in now, it'll affect the freezing temperature of the entire custard, so it will be harder to freeze. If we add it in at the end, when it's almost solidified, almost frozen, then you'll have a little less of a challenge getting it to the temperature you want.
Robin was caught almost just right in the nick of time.
Adrian saved me from making a huge mistake.
There's no mistakes here.
All right, so just to recap, we have our custard made and it's been sitting in the refrigerator, so it's about 40 degrees.
Sure, sure, sure.
And now we add our flavors. Yeah. So you can add your bananas in or you can add your custards into your bananas. And then you add your spices, a little bit of vanilla if you didn't already put vanilla in the base, and we're ready to go. How does it smell?
I think okay. What do you think?
It smells divine.
I mostly smell the vanilla custard. That's the...
There you go, Robin. I was just about to ask you to taste test it. What do you think, guys? Too much banana?
No, it's pretty good.
One thing that I think is really delicious about our ice cream, our banana bourbon ice cream...
Oh my god, that's so good.
...is that it's real ripe bananas. When you use fresh, ripe, real fruit, it's not going to taste like flavorings or commercial banana ice cream.
How much volume do we put in here? Do we fill it half? Do we fill it three quarters? Because we're whipping some air into this. And so
yeah, I think
there's a limited volume here.
I think it said like 60%. So there's
60%. You read the directions. I was definitely hoping that I was ad hoc-ing this, so what was gonna happen?
Yeah, so fill up that little ice cream chamber about 60% full and add in the beater. What that beater is gonna do is gonna move the custard from the outside where it's really cold by the frozen parts into the inside. It's gonna add a little bit of air too. That's exactly how our 36-quart ice cream maker works. It's just larger.
All right, I'm gonna turn mine on and let's see how this goes.
How long do we wait for this thing to keep spinning?
You know, I don't think there was a timer. I think you you watch it.
Actually, there is a right answer. You should turn it until you start seeing your ice cream custard look a little bit more like soft serve. You'll see a change in texture. I usually set a 30-minute timer and then come back and check on it.
A few moments later.
So a little bit of time has passed. What do you see? What does your ice cream look like? Is it still liquidy like before?
So I shut my churning off and now it's just keeping cold because the motor was struggling to churn. It had gotten thick enough that it was saying no more, can't do it. So it looks like ice cream, basically like soft serve ice cream.
So sort of almost like plaster? Like you can smush it with the back of a spoon, but it's not like the custard.
I'm keeping mine working. Oh, what's that? Oh, it stopped.
Houston, we have a problem.
I think that's the motor saying it's had enough.
So, yeah,
I think it's done.
Okay, so take a hard plastic spatula, not a rubber one that's flexible, because when it's sort of frozen on the outside, the hard plastic or a wooden spatula is gonna help you get everything out.
What about the bourbon?
Oh yeah, so I would say take it out of the container and then mix in your bourbon. If it were still at a consistency where the paddles were moving easily, we could add in the bourbon there and it would mix in with the little mixer. But now we should do it just with a spoon because in reality, your arm and your spatula is gonna be stronger than that little plastic blade.
Hey, Robin, we did it.
Yeah! And I'm home alone, which means I get to eat all this ice cream myself. Hello. So I'm also adding my caramel, which is the first time I ever made caramel. And I think I kind of burned it a little bit, but it still tastes pretty good.
All right, folks, this is it. Made it. It's a little soupy because it's a little melty, but it definitely has whipped air into it. So just as we record this, ooh, that looks good.
Yeah, that looks great.
Yeah.
I'm ready. Let's do this.
Yeah. Okay, let's do it, Robin, at the same time.
Yeah. Ready?
One, two, three. That's really good.
Mm. I think I could take more rum. I added rum instead of bourbon. I don't really taste it much.
There's a whole bottle on your table.
Yeah, you can still add more. It's not like adding more sugar or more emulsifier.
Yeah, I gotta eat this before it melts, you guys. That's the excuse. So mine is not too banana-y, but there's a subtle banana flavor.
What do I taste? I definitely taste more vanilla. I must have accidentally like this. Banana's not that strong, maybe because they're older bananas, but it doesn't taste like dessert banana.
The texture is pretty amazing. It's thick and creamy. It's like coating my mouth.
Yeah. I agree with that. I'm having the same experience as well.
So usually when I get store-bought ice cream, I tend to go for like a nice gelato or something, which is pretty dense, which is nice. This seems lighter, like more air-filled, which makes sense. It's churned.
I like this because it's like fluffy and like definitely has a smoothness to it. Victoria and the Jubilee Ice Cream had sent a sample of the ice cream that we make, which is the banana bourbon caramel. And so this is just for comparison to see what the differences are. I was trying that pudding test thing where it would just sit, but it just sits there. So I'm gonna try it. Now the caramel I can taste. You can see the cinnamon. The bourbon's a little bit at the end. I have to try one more to make sure that's right.
What's the texture like, Adrian?
Smooth. Creamy. I have to try again. Good.
You'll get to the bottom of it after a few
minutes. I will.
You need more data.
I need more data. That's really what this comes down to. Yeah, I think it's a fun activity. Like, I'm really interested in figuring out more things to see what happens.
Okay, guys, I'm so glad that you love the ice cream that you made. But if you have any ideas of what you want to see differently, what you want to make next time, what flavors you add, or what you would take away, That's the fun of ice cream. And honestly, that's the fun of cooking and experimenting in the kitchen. So don't be afraid to make mistakes. You should take this experiment and you should stay creative. Pull from whatever things you like, whatever memories you have, whatever flavors you love, and make better ice cream.
There are no bad ice creams. So if you just kind of give it a shot, you know, no one will know.
And you can always eat the evidence if it's bad.